Hi, I'm Rafael from Sonic Emotion Labs. In this video, I will show you how to tune your speaker configuration with the Wave 1 Designer. First, in the Designer, we click on the Tuning Mod button. The Designer asks if we want to upload or import our configuration. Let's select Import. Now, the Tuning Mode window appears. Let's select the speaker to show the tuning parameters. The tuning parameters consist of an equalizer and loudspeaker processing parameters. These parameters will help you to correct the defects of your individual speakers, equalize the sound between various speaker types, and treat your speakers differently depending on their location in your environment. The EQ consists of a low-pass and a high-pass filter, a low and a high shelf, 8 peak filters, and a makeup gain. Below the EQ, in the loudspeaker processing section, we can protect the loudspeaker with a limiter. For multi-way speakers, we can as well adjust the crossover frequencies and delay, gain, and eventual phase inversion of each output. One key feature of a designer is the possibility to assign each tuning parameter to either a single speaker, a subsystem, a room, or to assign the parameter to all the speakers. For example, we may want to correct the frequency response of all the speakers with a high-pass filter. To do so, we use the Assign Mode box located under the high-pass filter and set the Assign Mode to all loudspeakers. We might also want to correct the sound of a given subsystem. For example, the subsystem that contains the LCL speakers to harmonize their output with the rest of the system. Let's use the two first peak bands. Then, we set the Assign Mode to Subsystem. You can see that each speaker in the subsystem now shares the same parameters on the two peak bands. In the loudspeaker processing section, we can also assign the parameters to either one or multiple speakers by using the Assign Mode box located on top of the section. The tuning can be monitored by either listening to the individual loudspeakers or doing some acoustical measurements. For this purpose, we can use the test mode. When the test mode is activated, the selected audio input is directly routed to the selected speaker. We can select the audio input with this drop-down menu. Also, in the test menu, we can choose to test subsets of speakers, like an entire subsystem. All the speakers of the subsystem will then be activated one by one, which can help us to quickly perform a channel check or a sanity check of the loudspeakers. Please note that at any time, you can open the audio synchronization panel to adjust the synchronization parameters and check the audio cord status. That's it for the speaker tuning phase. In the next video, I will show you the Wave Performer software that is used to manage the audio sources in real time.